Although you have a very high-tech sound, in all the reviews of Ultravox that I've seen, they note Billy Currie has his own distinctive keyboard sound. Did you consciously set out to do that?
Yeah. You see, I went through all this period before of jamming and all this kind of thing, and I could never really relate to sort of rock and roll, except for its aggression and the guts and, you know, just the feel of it, you know. But after a while, I started realizing that I got off on a lot of the feeling from listening to classical composers like Bartok, Shostakovich. And so I thought, well, why not use it, you know? Why not try and put this into the sort of music, you know? And this is what we've kept on with, you know, and this has become our identity. We do things with a lot of keep the power of basic sound, like guitars or whatever, and we'll mix it. We never go into a specific area totally. We always try and keep like a violin with drum machine, you know. We'll always put something that offsets it from being totally synthesized. We're just building a program that gives you the ability to run six synthesizers with 16 ideas of 32 beats. So it's like an elaborate sequencer, you know. So each synthesizer with a voltage control, that's voltage that controls the pitch, coming out of the computer, will make each individual synthesizer play different melodies. And you've got really complete, total control of what kind of melody. So it's like a mini orchestra or something, you know. You can do up to about three or four octaves for each instrument.
So in the way that you and other musicians have come into rock music from a classical field, do you think we could eventually see people coming into pop music from a computer programming background?
Yeah, I think so, and it'll be a very peculiar breed of person. Because so when I'm working with this computer programmer, I can we offset each other, because he gets so incredibly involved in the meticulous little things of what's going on in there. But overall, I try and keep a distance, which is very difficult, because computers, until you get the program flowing, it's like a peculiar and weird world, you know. Just like the studio is to people when they first come in, you know, trying to get a distance from what's going on, you know, from being in that room and then coming back and listening to it, you know, trying to, it's as weird as that. It's also very stimulating, and the music that we're coming up with is surprisingly not sounding like your usual robotic stuff.